Yeah, of course, Larry. I'll rearrange my schedule. This afternoon's not a problem. And yeah, I know I always say that. Just remember when you hand out Christmas bonuses, okay? Thanks. Hi.
Hi.
So how'd it go?
Good. The kids love the brownies and the oatmeal chip cookies.
Well, you made them.
They knew they were from you.
Are you still tired, Mommy?
I'm just following doctor's orders, okay? I can follow orders, you know, occasionally.
So impressive.
Did you go finish your homework?
Okay, so I know it's not the same, but you did do the right thing because you've really been overdoing it. And just in case, I got the email address of one of the moms because your camera's fancier than mine.
I'm sure it's fine. I trust you. Too bad you don't trust me. That over there came from Blake this morning.
That's for Cassie's house. This is the flyer for the open house. I told you Blake wants you to sign off on it.
Why do we need an open house when we have a buyer?
Who? Me?
Mom, did we agree on that after the dinner party?
Agreed? No, you mentioned it one time. I thought you were joking.
Okay, I'll try again. You should buy Cassie's house. Did that sound funny?
Yes. It sounds ridiculous.
Okay, great. Thank you so much.
Okay. All right. So your meeting with the event planner for the Beacon is moved to next week, which means that you only have 2 meetings per day at the most, and none of them are back-to-back.
Well, unless Larry throws another one at me last minute.
Yeah, I don't know why you just don't tell him no once in a while.
Because sometimes it's smarter to say yes.
Okay, so next. The Beacon payroll. They need you to approve some overtime.
Okay, that's not due until the end of the week. Come here, have a look at this.
What is it?
I did a little search here. These are all the houses that are for sale that are comparable to Cassie's.
You just don't quit, do you?
Well, you're not going to believe me, so I'm going to give you proof.
Proof of what? That there are a lot of houses for sale?
That her asking price is extremely fair, if not a little low.
No, that asking price is a lot more than I sold the cottage for.
You have enough for a substantial down payment.
You're still talking about a huge amount of money. You don't just drop that overnight.
I'm talking about dropping it, like throwing it out of an airplane. I'm talking about an investment, a good investment in a house that you like a lot, that has plenty of room for Rafe. Come on, it's what you want.
I want Rafe to have some money for school when he gets out of jail.
You can have both. Why won't you believe me? Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry, because it's me. Right. No, I'm sure your local teller who has, what, a semester of junior college under her belt could tell you more than I could. What'd she tell you to do? Put in a money market, a long-term CD, or maybe it's stuck in some savings account earning you next to nothing?
You're my boss, and you're my friend. Right? So yes, if you have an opinion about something, absolutely, you let me know. But you can't make decisions like this for me. You're not the boss of my life.
I'm gonna go get ready for my meeting with Decker.
I don't see him, so you should sneak out and I will cover for you.
Why would I do that?
Because you need to rest more.
Oh, so you're gonna tell me how to live my life now?
Just trying to keep you healthy. Mm. And you're the one that said this meeting was not urgent.
No, I said the topic wasn't. My job is.
Do you think he's gonna fire you because you missed one meeting?
What if he does? I mean, you think I just can run out and get another job?
You don't need the money.
It's not just about the money. I happen to really like what I'm doing. I mean, there are health benefits. There's a job for Ava when she decides to come back. I don't have to work a gazillion hours a week, and I get to work from home.
No, I know. It's a very good opportunity.
It is an opportunity, and what is an opportunity but a chance? And if you don't take it, then it's all kind of meaningless, isn't it? The good part is I was smart enough to realize that. Not everyone does.
2 for the price of 1, my kind of lunch.
Well, unfortunately, Natalia's not sticking around. It bore her out of her mind.
I do have a lot of things to do.
When are you gonna let me steal her from you?
As soon as you can convince her it's a good idea.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh.
Hey! Oh, please tell me you're not leaving. Dad just canceled out on me.
Oh. Hey, you don't still have a mortgage, do you?
What? No. Well, I did. Why do you ask? I mean, I thought you sold your cottage.
I did. But, Cassie's house is up for sale.
Ooh, that's a great place.
Yeah, it's expensive. I think the mortgage would be huge.
When Eleni and I, we moved into our house, I had nightmares for, like, weeks. You know, would I have enough money if Marina needed braces, or if my car broke down, would I have enough money to buy another car?
Shouldn't I save that money for Rafe's lawyer? Because I have the thought of debt. That's why I don't have any credit cards.
Well, yeah. Who's that with Olivia?
Larry Decker, her boss.
Galaxy Hotels?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I figured she'd be with some rich business type.
Did you know that Olivia grew up poor?
I did know that. But look at her now, who would have thought?
Not me. Thank you for the drink.
You're welcome. Ah, maybe next time we'll throw in some food there, huh?
So in the end, you were glad you bought that house?
You know what, in retrospect, you needed a lot of work. But, no regrets.
Really?
Really. Well, up until the day I got divorced.
Sorry, did you need more time?
Actually, no. I just found out I have a conference call. I'm sorry, Olivia. I know this is supposed to be a working lunch.
It's okay. Larry was telling me about a hedge fund. Aren't you glad you weren't with us?
Okay, yeah, it's a little dry. Hedge funds in Hong Kong, but I'm telling you, my info is solid, and this is a great fit for you, okay? Just don't wait too long, Olivia.
Thanks. Thanks for the tip.
That's for you. I hope your son's doing okay in that new facility.
Oh, thank you. I didn't know you knew about Rafe.
You're important to Olivia, so you're important to me. See ya.
Bye. All right, come on. I'll drive you home.
Don't you have another shift at company?
I don't have to be there quite yet.
Huh. Well, you know what? I'm gonna take a cab. That way you'll have more time to count your money.
You're telling me the truth. This is much better.
Come on, do you see any bruises?
Well, it could be underneath your shirt.
Come on, what are you doing? There's a guard in here. You serious?
I know. You don't have to.
Don't what? Take off my shirt? That's kind of
You don't
nasty.
Have to protect me.
Ma, look, this is a different prison, all right? It's not the old place. It's minimum security. You did that for me.
Okay, I know that you don't want to tell me anything bad. It's fine, but you have to promise me if you get hurt, you have to tell somebody. You tell a lawyer or the guard or tell Daisy. I don't care who.
I'd much rather give you good news.
All right, don't tease me because this is not the day.
I'm not teasing you, Ma. This place is not the old place. It's different. They have classes here. They have a library. You know, I can, you know, get my GED and walk out. I can go to college.
Oh, Rafe.
I know that it's expensive and everything, but you know, but I didn't even think about going to a fancy school until you and Gus got married, and that was for, what, 6 months? You know, I can go to community college. There's nothing to be ashamed of. Ma, and don't do that, all right? Because, look, I'm in prison, and any school is a big step up. Mommy, look, seriously, I didn't even know that we were poor until we moved to Springfield. All right, and before that, I didn't even think too much about college. At best, I thought maybe I'd be, like, a mechanic. Which is nothing, there's nothing wrong with that. It's a good job. But it's just, you know, now I know that I have choices.
Is that what I made you think? That you didn't have any other choices?
Stop. No. All right, come on. I used to know what to do to make you feel better. What's wrong? Have I been in prison too long?
No. There's got to be another way. You know what? People don't just stay poor. They figure it out. And they figure out how to get ahead and how to provide for their families and how to have money in an emergency.
Okay. Look, everything's going to be fine. Why? Do you trust me? All right.
And that's why they called it Thanksgiving. Because just for a moment, everyone stopped. Be grateful for what they had.
And they all stopped fighting.
Oh, so you heard us, Natalia, and me before.
It sounded like you were mad at her. Did you give her a timeout?
Oh, you know, grown-ups don't get timeouts, although we really, really should. We really need them. We just make mistakes, Sam. We make really big mistakes.
Didn't you just eat at Towers?
Does Olivia keep you busy enough?
I'm not ashamed of being a waitress. You know, my son is going to need some money for college soon. So. It doesn't pay as much as Galaxy, but it does pay.
I'll take the greasiest thing on the menu. That bad?
Oh, no, I... Could you tell me a little bit about the investment you were telling Olivia about?
I thought that stuff bored you.
Well, not if it makes what you said it would. And if you tell me it's not too late to get in,